Good morning and welcome. Yesterday we had a better than expected Empire Manufacturing out, but it failed to lead equities higher. And that was mainly due to the fact there was a report out showing, documented data-wise, that there are probabilities that earnings or profit margins, especially within U.S. companies, is going to have a setback quite significant for the rest of the year. Also, be aware that when we face or when we experience equity markets going lower, you might experience quite significant surge in equities afterwards, shortly afterwards. This is simply due to the fact that fund managers that are behind their allocation or behind their benchmark will take any opportunity given a setback to buy into equity markets. So I don't think, even though we are bearish and we believe that equity markets should go lower for looking from a pure valuation perspective, I don't think technically it's going to happen in a short term, because the need for these fund managers to step in and have their allocation right and follow their benchmark is so big that they'll pick any opportunity to go back into markets and support them. We saw VIX yesterday up by 15%, and stock futures this morning is for S&P 500 also indicates a positive opening. Earnings-wise, we had Vestas out in 21 minutes ago, and from the U.S. it's Home Depot coming out today, and Hewlett Packard after closing. Home Depot is quite significant, quite important, because it's going to tell us something about the U.S. consumer and how much money they're going to spend or have spent on the decoration of their houses. Lowe's was out yesterday, which is Home Depot's major competitor, and they were quite negative for the rest of the 2009 earnings. So we'll look for Home Depot. Also, you can tell your clients that we start to make small videos on the TradingFloor.com. On the 100 biggest companies, when they report earnings, we'll have a comment out on earnings. We'll go out and make Vestas now, and Home Depot will make this afternoon, and Hewlett Packard will make tomorrow morning. The most important economic data releases today is from Eurozone. That's not from Eurozone, that's from UK CPI, month on month. We expect that the CPI from the UK, at least year-on-year reading, will be more towards the deflationary side than expected by markets. The year-on-year expectation in markets is 1.5%, and we expect in the range of 1.2%. Germany is having a SU figures out this morning. If you look at the current situation, expectations, the market expects minus 85, and we believe they'll come out in the range of something about minus 88, minus 89, a bit to the negative side. We don't believe that that German is around to set for a recovery in the economic wise yet. And then we have US PPI out, and our expectations is pretty much in line with markets. But also look for US housing starts. The ever troubled US housing market is going to have some more data releases today. And we need to see a rebound, a significant rebound, both in terms of prices and in terms of demand, before you can say that the US has recovered. Euro dollar, we are neutral to negative. Euro yen, we're neutral to negative. Dollar yen, we're neutral to negative. Cable, we're neutral to negative. And surprise, surprise, Aussie dollar, we're neutral to negative. Equities, we believe we're going to see a bit of a rebound today from yesterday's sell-off. And on commodities as such, we are somewhere in the neutral to negative territory. We are selling on rallies in commodities, and in equities, we're buying on breaks. That's pretty much it. Any questions, short stories, or even comments? No? Well, safe trading.